Hello and greetings from Iceland, but I'm only going to cover the land uplift today since we just got some interesting satellite data and I'm also going to tell you a bit about my upcoming photo tour. But first, the action in Iceland. Here we have the land uplift and the biggest news must be that it's more widespread than previously believed and like last year, the epicenter looks as it's directly under Mount Thorbjörn now. But in fact, it started a bit further west this time. And only a few days ago when I made a long video about Grindavík, we were under the impression that the land uplift was mostly taking place west of Mount Thorbjörn or 1.4 cubic kilometers of magma on the move. And during the third land uplift episode last year, it was believed that high pressurized gas was the main cause back then or before the Geldingadalir eruption started. But as for this land uplift, it's the red stuff. So this is one of the days that leaves me with more questions than answers, especially about the pipelines under there. But it has to be good news that there is this decrease in earthquake activity just now, but the magma is at 4 or 5 kilometers depth. But then, as many of us remember from last year, after a shaky period that suddenly slowed down, one of our experts stated that this would turn into nothing, and 24 hours later, the eruption came up without anyone noticing it on the seismometers. But the people in Grindavík shared it. So the last kilometers up to the surface were in a way like a warm knife slicing through a chunk of butter. So it's not necessarily good news that the seismic activity is dropping now, but impossible to tell for sure, of course. And our experts stated that the more often we get the land uplift, like it's the fourth one now, the more likely it gets that this ends up with an eruption. And it's even possible that magma from the Geldingadalir eruption found its way to this location, or so they say, or after that the eruption came to an end, which is a bit odd because it's been generally considered to be a separate volcanic system. But it's not for me to tell. And the land uplift is now 4 centimeters at its highest point, west of the mountain, or during the last 12 days. And there was a meeting in Grindavík last night where our experts were going over this situation with the townspeople. The word evacuation has not been mentioned seriously so far, but I did mention in my last update that lava barriers were designed last year, but it was decided to hold on with the bulldozers until such barriers were truly needed. And I got some remarks in the comment section about that, or why don't they just go ahead and make them? Good question indeed. And it's also a hard question. And I don't have all the information, but let me explain what I can from what I know now. And first of all, it's a major construction that leaves its mark on the nature and the town. Like those avalanche barriers that I flew over just recently, changing this town forever. So I understand why people are reluctant to change the appearance of the town, especially since it's not clear from where the threat would come from. And looking at the widespread land uplift and all the old vents that pose threat to the town now, it's understandable up to a limit that they want to hold on until we know what we will be dealing with. And we were told last year that owners of heavy machinery will be on standby when needed. So in case of an emergency, it won't take them long to get moving. But then we might get into a situation where we just can't control anything at all. So it's a tough decision that awaits our experts. Like if we're meant to evacuate places like the Blue Lagoon. But guests there have been made aware of the situation and life goes on. And I see also a reason to mention that the land around here, on the westernmost part of the peninsula, has been sinking a bit, or between May 7th and the 19th. But I recently covered an earthquake swarm over there, and I'm linking to that video. And it's directly on the plate boundary, or south of the bridge between the continents, as it stands there as a symbol for the forces that are constantly splitting my country apart. But things are cooling down a bit today, even though we have this earthquake threat hanging over us in Reykjavík, and I will cover that better soon. But as for me, I'm on my way south again, not because I expect an eruption to start soon, even though it might, but I always need footage, and the 500 gigabytes I brought back from my last tour have been very helpful recently to explain the land around there. And I've only showed you a little portion of it so far. And this time I'm also using a chance to capture some of the sweeter sides of Iceland. And I want to thank those of you who have been so kind to use the donation option on my channel. But I am taking time from other jobs to create enough content to make my channel self-sustainable by time. But I am reaching my 30,000 subscriber target now and very proud of that achievement. And thankful for a clean and good comment section as well. But it's your interest that keeps me going after all. So due to my trip, there might be a few days until my next video. But if something is however about to happen on the peninsula, I will be nearby for the next days. I know the land there very well. And I do have a long range drone. And I know about safe spots to work from in case of an eruption soon. And I might just as well do live broadcasts from there in addition to my regular updates. So I am getting ready for just about anything now. And in case of decreased earthquakes, like we see today, I will be back next week with a stuffed hard drive. But the land is getting greener now. And my best work with the drone has yet to come. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the Volcano Island, Iceland.